Morning to you, man. Morning to your love. I say, Africa must wake up, you sleeping sons of Jacob, for what tomorrow may bring, may a better day come. Yesterday we were kings, can you tell me, young ones, who are we today?
But this is an African scientist holding the bones, the remains of an ancient African ancestor named Dinknesh, which means you are wonderful. These are the bones commonly known as Lucy, 3.4 million years old. Next. We're going to go through these quickly. This looks like an ancient ruler. This is called the Ishango bone. This is 25,000 years old. And this is one of the earliest known uses of mathematics from the Congo, the place we think Tarzan and Jane used to live. Next. Imhotep. Everybody should know him. Every African child should know Imhotep. If you don't know anybody else, know him. Not Django Unleashed, but Imhotep. Okay? Not Beyonce, Imhotep. Imhotep is the world's first scientist. He's the father of medicine, long before Hippocrates, the original Hippocrate. He's the person who designed the world's first large stone building. He's credited with the expression, eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow we may die. He was a physician, a magician, an astronomer, a high priest, a dentist, the Grand Vizier. He was so renowned as a writer, 2,000 years after his death, he was identified not only as a god of medicine, but as kind of a god of writing. And other Egyptian writers, other Kemite writers, other African writers, before they would write something, they would have a libation ceremony. And they would spill ink in the ground. And not water or gin or snaps, but ink in the ground. And ask themselves, could there ever be another like Imhotep? So we see why my brother Imhotep has taken that name. He has a lot to live up to. Next. And then if you want to see what African people can do, look here. If you want to see how we've fallen, look there. If you want to see what we're capable of, look there. And then you ask yourself the question, how do we move from the pyramids to the projects? These are built in, Egypt is in Africa. Did you know Egypt was in Africa? See, a lot of people are a little confused about that. If you watch the BBC and CNN, you would think Egypt is not in Africa. But Egypt has always been. I've been in Egypt 22 times. It's been in Africa every time. I was there last year. It was in Africa last year. I would think we would have heard something if it had relocated to another continent. And the people who built these were Africans. And they weren't enslaved Africans. They were free Africans. And these were national construction projects. The one in the background, of course, is known as Khufu on the Horizon of the Great Pyramid. It's 486 feet high. It sits on 13 acres. It's composed of 2.3 million blocks of granite stone that weigh about 5,000 pounds each. The stone was taken from 500 miles away. Let's say you're going to build something here, but you get the stone in Charlotte, North Carolina, and you transport it here. And it's not glued together or cemented together. The stone was cut so precisely that it was fitted together like pieces of a puzzle. And when they finished them, they coated them with something called limestone and polished it and buffed it and shined it until it would glitter like diamonds. So imagine a diamond 486 feet high on 13 acres of land, and there's no clouds in the sky, and the sun came up. Imagine the visual effect. You could see it hundreds of miles across the Sahara. That's our legacy. This is why everybody wants to claim it. But they can't have it. And nobody's been able to duplicate those. The Arabs, who are Johnny-come-latelys to Africa, who are invaders of Africa, although the first people of Arabia were black people, the people who are in power now are not. They were so impressed by these monuments when they came to Kemet in 640 that they said, the world fears time, but time fears the pyramids. Speaking of time, let's discard these notions of CP time. Africans are the people who invented the concept of time. We're the first people to have a clock, first people to have a calendar. We should always be on time. In fact, we must run while they walk. We don't have time to be late. We didn't build those because people came when they felt like it or when it was convenient. Discipline is something we are sorely lacking today. And there will be a million reasons why we came late. And they will all be good reasons, but none of them will work for us.
This is about, we're in 2013, whatever you want to call it. We're in this era time, and this is our time. Understand, you are living in historic times. You don't even realize that. These are historic times. There's no point in our history over here where we have had access to this much information. We don't have to ask ourselves who we are today. We know it if we listen to the wisdom of our ancestors and our elders. We know who we are. But you're confused when you don't listen, when you watch the TV all day long, when you read those novels all day long, when you're on the internet on the wrong sites all day long, when you're on Facebook talking about your pimples and that stupid stuff all day long. That's why you're still confused. When you can easily get to my door, it wasn't hard for you to get to him. That's when we started communicating. It's easy to get to the ones that's doing the work. You just gotta wanna reach out and get to them. So we can go. Did I say anything to make any sense to anybody?
Yeah.
If it makes some sense to you, this is what I need you to do. You have to act on it. You have to go home, go where you go at, reflect upon what I said. Reflect on it. Think about it. And then act. We need actors. We need people that's willing to be sincere and dedicated to make this thing happen. Because we can and we will win. You don't have to question that anymore. Can and we will. You got a number of organizations. You got the African Village. And I'll put your hand up. African Village. Came off from D.C., put y'all up in the study class, go ahead. Y'all see some guys in the house. Y'all the shots still here. Y'all the honey to it. Y'all the face time. You and I, hey. You got the Paradise Liberation Movement, PLM. Everybody be as committed as we are. But I believe what the Bible said is correct. I stand on that. I know Palmer said to way he said a lot. We have to belong to some organization. We have to get involved with some organization so we can be successful. I look forward to working with all the organizations that came out, we can broaden our network. You know, we got the Pan African Dance Solidarity that's coming up this year, September 14th. You know, get on board with that because it's a movement and it's growing. And we're gonna unify our people throughout the world with this. But we need people that's ready to take a stand. We need a standard.